Hey, welcome to Fix by Doc. It is 8:40 on Friday, May 14th, and I made it to Damascus, and I'm at Sundog Outfitters in Subway. There's Sundog Outfitters over there in the parking lot here. Just got dropped off this morning, and I spent the night at Mount Rogers over at Partnership Shelter, and then dropped the vehicle off, and then Sundogs picked me up and brought me down here to Damascus, and then I'll hike back. In a couple of days I'll start hiking back to Partnership Shelter and then catch my van and drive back home. So today is the 14th and I should be home by the 23rd. So I'll spend the next 10 days on the trail. And I'm going to spend the first 2 days here in Damascus at Trail Days, and then the rest of the time on the trail. So there's my backpack. Got all my gear ready. And I'm supposed to meet a couple of people here. One of my friends from YouTube is supposed to give me a text about 9:30, and meet me somewhere around here. It's 8:45 now, so I'm just waiting on his text. And then we'll meet up and then plan the rest of the day. Got to go down and see where I'm going to camp out for tonight, tomorrow night. See what campground I'm going to go stay at. I'll let you know how things go, and when I get down to into town, we'll talk to you later. Show you around. Vendors area. People getting set up before the rush.
Hi, I'm Kent. They call me Hickory.
Hey, and Suge's not here right now, but we got his better half.
He wants to know where to camp.
He had to go home. He was tired.
And you got to check out these guys' channels. They are the coolest, funniest guys on YouTube.
He makes me do it.
I think you have just as much fun doing it as you
do. Oh, it's always fun. Yeah. It's our annual birthday trip, you know, in the spring. Actually, today's his birthday, May 14th.
Yeah? Well, tell him we all say happy birthday to him.
We'll do it, man.
Yeah, he's a great guy. I hope he never dies. I hope you never die either, because I don't know what we're going to do. When you two are gone off of YouTube...
We're probably going to die together, because you know it only hurts if you live.
Yeah. Okay. When you two are gone off of YouTube, it's going to be a sad day.
Well, you know, there's reruns. You know, I can play those for years.
Yeah.
Re-editing. Somebody will buy the rights. And then re-edited.
Well, it's glad to meet you.
You too, man.
I'm really glad I ran into you.
Well, if I ever need anything fixed, I'll give you a holler.
Thanks.
I'm not kidding.
Alright, welcome to Fix by Doc, and this is my Vargo titanium folding wood stove that I normally pack when I go backpacking in the summertime. And it's my go-to summertime wood stove. and this is my Fargo Titanium Triad XE alcohol stove. I did not bring the base with it because I don't intend to use it as a standalone stove this trip. And what I had intended to do is just use it inside. It's going to be hard to do with this stove one-handed right now, but I intended to use it inside here like this, which I have done many, many, many times. Then you light it up and then you just stick your pot on there like that, and the folding wood stove becomes its windscreen. The only downside to this is that it's an awful large gap between the wood alcohol stove and where the pot sits up here. So you use a little bit more fuel than necessary. And of course I'm at Damascus Trail Days right now. And I was at the Vargo stand where they were showing off the new gear and stuff like that. And they had the new alcohol stoves. And this is the alcohol stove right here. And they sold it to me at a discounted price for $25. And it's really nice. It looks a lot like your standard soda can stoves, which is basically an identical replication of that, but it's made out of titanium. And what's the cool part is, though, is it's thicker, like twice as thick, or approximately, I'm trying to hold it here for comparison, about twice as thick, roughly, and which means it'll hold a lot more fuel for cooking time. So you can cook a lot longer with it, and I do a lot of baking and stuff, you know, like pizzas and baking breads and cakes. So it's nicer to have the more fuel holding capability. This one here, when baking cakes or muffins and stuff, I usually have to fill it up twice. You know, the initial fill up, and then it empties, and then fill it up a second time. Now the thing is that you could set this down there like that, but it's still got the huge gap down there, which is still quite a distance. What is nice though is they have made a rack, so to speak, for that. This folds up nice and flat, and it's also made out of titanium and it's real light. And again, trying to do this one-handed is kind of difficult, but it sits in there like that and brings the alcohol stove up to the proper height, giving it your 1-inch distance that you want from your alcohol stove to your pot, so that you get your proper cooking distance. And now your wood stove and your alcohol stove work in unison, and it makes perfect setup. So you can't go wrong with a wood stove combined with an alcohol stove, especially when they're built to work together like this. So I can't wait to try this out. I'm going to be leaving this one behind. I leave Trail Days. The plan is to leave Trail Days on Monday morning. I'll stop at the post office and mail off my goodies. Yes, I did win another backpack, and I also won a brand new pair of Sierra Designs rain pants and a bunch of other goodies I was able to collect from vendors. So hopefully I can pack those up and send them home on Monday, and then hit the trail and then spend the next several days and on the trail until the 23rd, working my way back up to the van. And so I just wanted to show you that real quick. It's a pretty cool stove, and I have no doubt in my mind that this stove is going to work awesome on the trail because it's a Vargo product. And when you want good, top quality, number one camping mess kit, go with Vargo. You can't go wrong. So, all right, thanks. Really cool teepee tent setup.
Did you get a sport?
I got a sport, yeah. No, I dropped the whole damn thing. And dumped them on the ground.
Did you really?
Yeah.
It's just the field, all in the woods back there. Full of tents and everything too. This is my shelter. Just my tarp set up like I usually do. My bivy sack, my backpack. And it's been raining a little off and on. So. But everything in there has been staying dry.
That's good news.
And hopefully it doesn't pour down too hard.
I guess.